Coming up, hundreds of Harvard students flocked to see Emma Watson last Friday, but their view was blocked by two groups of boys throwing some type of ball around.
And 3,000 students received an email from ex-grad student Wei Gu, claiming she was unfairly kicked out of Harvard for mental health issues. Yep, nothing says I'm not crazy like a mass email to thousands of strangers.
Classes can wait.
You're on Harvard Time. Welcome to On Harvard Time.
It's fall again at Harvard, and you know what that means.
Punch season?
Nope. Flu season. Have you seen the little biggies crawling in the dirt? The university has been rocked by an outbreak of swine flu cases over the last 4 months.
The spread of the virus was so rapid at last year's graduation that Dean Evelyn Hammonds had to take drastic measures to protect herself.
But I wanted to let you know that UHS is recommending that we forego the traditional handshakes and embraces that accompany graduation ceremonies.
How historic. This may be the first time Harvard has forgone a tradition since they made Hammonds the dean of the college. Fortunately, the UHS ban didn't restrict all forms of greetings.
That's more hypocritical than the Say Yes to Drugs campaign.
Our campaign is all about increasing global...
Just... say yes.
This year, to keep students healthy, UHS is offering what they consider helpful tips. These include such medical breakthroughs as washing your hands with soap and water and throwing your used tissues in the trash. What's next? I have to stop eating my own feces?
UHS has also advised students with flu-like symptoms to stay away from other people and remain in your room while drinking plenty of clear fluids. Sounds like my Saturday night.
The university has also strongly recommended that students with symptoms such as chills, headaches, or tiredness refrain from going to class. Wait, we don't have to go to class if we're tired? Well, that explains my ECTEN lecture last week.
What are you doing here?
But if you must go out in public while sick, the university advises that you wear a surgical mask. That's just embarrassing. What if I just got everyone around me to wear one instead?
Say SARS!
One of the obvious ways that UHS is fighting swine flu is by installing Purell sanitation stations in select locations on campus.
Here's Ryan Halperin to explain the many uses of Purell.
Roll the clip. You're so clean, Purell, but so dirty.
Thanks, Ryan. And now a special report from Asim Shukla on those kids who, you know, those kids that have a thing where they're always like, you see them? Just take a look.
You've seen them around campus. Scooter girl, suit kid,
fedora boy.
Today, we take an in-depth look into the that kid subculture.
Some people here, they want to change the world. They want to have an impact. I do too. But in my own way, I want to be the Gloves Kid.
Meet Gloves Kid. He has a real name, but he's asked that we not reveal it to preserve his reputation.
I want to be the Gloves Kid. I want to be the kid that wears the gloves. Always. I want to concentrate on gloves. I want to concentrate in gloves, with the secondary and heat never leaving my fingers. I wear the gloves so you don't have to.
But the Gloves Kid is not the only that kid on campus.
It stopped raining, but I just kept holding on to it. I need my umbrella. It protects me from the mind control rays and the rain.
A simple stroll through a dormitory hallway, and I've already spotted one.
Yeah, I wear a bathrobe. Sometimes it falls off. But I'd say it's still worth it.
You can find them in the library. In the science center. And even in lecture.
I'm the kid who looks like Steven Pinker.
I mean,
oh, beep.
Everywhere.
I'm in Canada, I say. Canada is me. Rush epic. Where are you going?
So there you have those weird kids with the things. To finish, I believe Gloves Kid put it best.
All we want is to be loved for who we are, and to wear gloves all the time.
In recent Harvard news, Dan Balls and Haynes Johnson, the co-authors of The Battle for America 2008, The Story of an Extraordinary Election, hosted a dinner with students at the IOP. Here to report is Rebecca Margulies.
Balls and Johnson, just taking a ride.
This week, the IOP opened its doors to accommodate the Balls Johnson team. The crowd packed into the building, jostling each other and standing upright, hoping to catch a glimpse of Johnson, or at least of Balls. The crowd included IOP President Mary Cox and members of the Student Advisory Committee. The Sack and Cox were very excited to see Balls and Johnson.
How did it go?
Everyone who attended agrees. Balls and Johnson were the total package. They gave a stimulating oral presentation that touched on hard-to-reach areas of the discussion. The first to speak was Balls. I mean Johnson. There I go, getting my Balls and my Johnson confused again.
It happens.
They started out quiet, soft, but soon grew into their own, drilling in the important points. The session went on long into the night.
How long was it?
Very long, and it got to be pretty hard going. The two speakers didn't always agree. In fact, there was a vast difference between many of their views. With mounting enthusiasm, Balls and Johnson thrust their genius forward again and again, and the crowd was more than happy to take it, repeatedly.
I bet they were so happy they came.
Okay, wait. And then Balls and Johnson busted some hot, spermy knowledge all over their faces.
Ew.
Keep it together, Zimbler. Thanks, Rebecca, and thank you for watching.
Now here's a moment that could happen only at Harvard. If we were two Lego blocks, even the Harvard University graduating class of 2010 couldn't put us back together again. When I bring boy, up on my face, boy.
Your friends.